Hi students, this is Kanan Daksana back to you with description of order Diptera. Insect order Diptera, the word can be divided into two. Di means two and tera means wings, means the insects having two wings. Two wings means one pair of wings. This is the major insect order, both in ecological and human terms. The insects of this order are of medical and economic importance. There are about 120,000 species of insects of dipterans described. They have a single pair of wing, which is present on mesothorax, hence these are known as mesothoracic wings. The venation present in the wings is very sparse, we may say it is reduced. Hind wings are reduced into haltiers. Mouth parts are usually forming a proboscis, which is adapted for piercing. Mandibles are rarely present. Labium is distally expanded into fleshy lobe. Labium is also known as the lower lip. So this is extended into or expanded into a fleshy lobe. Then pro and metathorax are small in dipterans and are fused with the mesothorax. Tarsi are 5-segmented. Metamorphosis is complete, which means the life cycle consists of 4 stages, the eggs, larva, the pupa and the imago or adult. The larvae are mainly cruciform and apodous, that is without legs, and are frequently with head reduced and retracted. The tracheal system is variable. Tracheal system is the system of respiration in insects. So this is of different types in case of dipterans. Pupa is either free or it is enclosed in a case which is known as puparium. The pupa is adacticus and exudate in forms. They have vast feeding habits. They are nectar feeders. Animals from or insects from order Diptera are nectar feeders. Detritivorous feeding on detritus. Frugivorous feeding on fruits. Omnivorous and carnivorous or sanguivorous. Sanguivorous, I hope you know, means blood sucking or feeding on blood. Then we come to the distribution and ecology of the dipterans. So dipterans are cosmopolitan in distribution and found in almost all habitats. About 120,000 species are grouped into 2 suborders, Nematocera and Brachycera. Dipterans live in aquatic water. This is mainly the fresh water. Then they also live in semi-aquatic or moist terrestrial environments. Commonly found in the soil, in plant or animal tissues and in carrion or dung. Carrion means the dead bodies of animals or human. Some species of dipterans are phytophagous, feeding on plants. They may feed on dead organic matter or they may be parasite on other animals. You know a large number of species of dipterans which are parasite, for example mosquitoes. Especially they are parasite on vertebrates and other arthropods also. The adult forms of dipterans live in a variety of habitats and they display enormous variation in appearance and their lifestyle. Okay, so let's come to the next slide. We come to the mouth parts of dipterans. Dipterans have ostellate type of mouth parts. Ostellate means a ostellum is present in their mouth parts, which is meant for sucking, which is meant for absorbing. So these dipterans mainly collect food in liquid form. Their mouth parts are of various types, diverse types. For example, mosquitoes have piercing and sucking type of mouth parts. Flies, house flies have sponging type of mouth parts. So there may be diverse type of mouth parts in this order. In some families, the proboscis is adapted for sponging and lapping. Ostellate mouth parts collect food in the liquid forms. In several families, the proboscis, which is also known as a rostrum, is adapted for sponging. Some of the flies are predators of other arthropods like robber flies. Most of them are external parasites like mosquitoes, horseflies that feed on the blood of their vertebrate hosts like humans, wild and domestic animals. Then we come to the life history of dipterans. The female of dipterans oviposits as close to the food source as possible. The eggs hatch immediately after being laid, or the flies may be ovoviviparous also. The larvae in this case are apodous and eucephalous. Apodous means without legs, and eucephalous means developed head. These are like wrigglers in case of mosquitoes. They may be hemicephalous as in case of maggots, which are the larvae of most of the flies, or they may have the head condition as acephalous, which means without head, as present in maggots of house flies. The larvae are voracious feeders. They feed a lot and on a lot of things. Pupae of these animals take various forms. In some cases they develop inside a silk like cocoon, or they may be free also. After emerging from the pupa, the adult fly lives for a very short span. It has a short life. So these animals complete their life history in a few days or weeks only. This is a flow chart I have made for the classification of Diptera. So you can see here, order Diptera is divided into two suborders, suborder Nematocera and suborder Brachycera. There are no superfamilies described, but suborder Nematocera has 8 families. These are Psychodidae, family Culicidae, family Simulidae, Chironomidae, Bibionidae, Cecidomidae, Tipulidae, Mycetophilidae. Then Brachycera is divided again into 11 families. These are Tabenidae, Acylidae, Bombylidae, Syrphidae, Agromycidae, Drosophilidae, Gastrophilidae, Mucidae, Caliphoridae, Tachinidae, and Hippobossidae. We know the examples of common examples of these families. Family Psychodidae includes the moth flies or the sand fly. Family Culicidae includes mosquitoes. Family Simulidae includes black fly, buffalo gnat, turkey gnat. Family Chironomidae includes non-biting midges or larvae, which are also known as bloodworms. Family Bibionidae includes march flies or love bugs. Then family Cecidomidae includes gall midges. Mycetophilidae includes fungus gnats. Tipulidae includes crane fly or daddy long legs. Then suborder Brachycera has different members. Family Tabanidae includes horsefly, gadflies. Family Acelidae has rubber flies. Family Bombylidae has bee flies. Syrphidae has hover flies and drone flies. Agromycetae includes leaf miners. Family Drosophilidae includes the fruit flies. Family Gastrophilidae includes bot flies. Musidae includes Musca domestica or house fly, which is known to us very well. Family Calliphoridae includes blowflies. These are also known as blue bottles. Family Tachinidae includes tachinid fly. And Hippobossidae includes louse flies, also known as Hippobosca maculata. This is present on the cattle, parasitic on the cattle. So, suborder Nematocera. In suborder Nematocera, the antennae are many segmented. They are usually longer than head and thorax, and the segments are similar. Arista is present at the tip. Pronotum is distinct from mesonotum. Notum word denotes to the chitinous plates present on the dorsal surface of the insect. So pronotum is distinct or different from mesonotum, distinctly clear. Larvae are either eucephalic or hemicephalic. They are often aquatic. In suborder Brachycera, the antennae are three segmented with terminal arista or style, labial palpi, which are part of the lower lip or labium, usually are one or two segmented. The larva head is usually retractile with vertical biting mandibles. Pupae are obtect. Pupation is usually in puparium. So this is these are the pictures of a few insects or few dipterans from different families of Diptera. This is first is the sandfly. Sandfly is from order from family Psychodidae. Then there is Anopheles from family Culicidae. This is Simulium indicum from the family Simulidae. Then this is a Chironomus species, which is from family Chironomidae. Then there is a species named Bibio species, which are commonly known as love bugs or march flies. This is from the family Bibionidae. Then family Cecidomidae has gall midges. Then family Mycetophilidae has fungus gnats. So you can see here all the, this is a fungus gnat. Family Tipulidae has crane fly or daddy long legs. This is a crane fly. It has long legs, hence is also known as daddy long legs. Tipulidae. Then there is suborder Brachycera, which is family Tabanidae. So this is Tabanus rubidus, also known as horsefly. Then family Acelidae, in which there are robber flies. Family Bombylidae, which have bee flies. This is also known as, this is a zoological name is Bombylius species. Then family Syrphidae has hoverfly or drone fly. This is from family Syrphidae. Then family Agromycetae includes the leaf miners. Example Phytomyza. I think we don't have it here. Then Agromycetae has leaf miners and Phytomyza atricornis or pea leaf miner is from this family. Then there is family Drosophilidae, which includes Drosophila. Here it is. We have Agromycetae is here. Then we have Drosophila from family Drosophilidae. Then Gastrophilidae includes botflies. This is a botfly. Then family Musidae includes housefly or Musca domestica. This you know very well. Family Calliphoridae includes blowfly. This is the blowfly, greenish blue in color. This fly is mainly flesh feeder. Okay, they are also, their larvae are saprophagus. Then there is family Tachinidae, and the fly is known as Tachinus species. This is Tachinid fly. Then there is one family Hippobossidae, and the example is Hippobosca. So these are a few examples of the family of Diptera. You keep on reading again, going through this video again, so that you might be able to remember some of these things. Okay, keep learning and enjoy learning.